So my name is Elizabeth Cochran. I work at the U.S. Geological Survey.
I'm Brian Swanson. I work for the California Geological Survey.
My name is Judy Chester, and I'm a professor at Texas A&M University.
My name is David Oglesby, and I'm a professor of geophysics at UC Riverside.
Emily Brodsky.
Jerry Costin.
Ray Cho.
I'm a professor at the University of California, Santa Cruz.
Department of Applied Math, Naval Postgraduate School, Monterey.
I'm with the U.S. Navy.
I am Christine Goulet, and I'm an earthquake engineer.
My name's David Gill.
I'm Marsha Lucas.
Fabio Silva.
Kevin Milner.
Well, I'm a research programmer here at SCEC.
I'm Carrie Ann Bergen. I'm a graduate student at Stanford University.
My name is Tom Jordan. I'm director of the Southern California Earthquake Center. We gather information about earthquakes. Then we synthesize that information into models of earthquake processes that can be used for predictive purposes, that can inform society about future earthquake hazards.
Earthquake system science is understanding the way earthquakes work over all relevant time scales, over all relevant spatial scales, and to use that understanding to anticipate how strong the ground is going to shake, how likely that is to happen, such that we can deal with the hazards that earthquakes pose.
It has such broad societal value, informing engineers about earthquake hazards to help evaluate buildings.
The community modeling environment provides us with the infrastructure we need to do the large-scale simulations of earthquake processes. We are one of the largest users of supercomputers in the United States.
SCEC basically develops and supports several scientific software packages. One is called the Broadband Platform, the Unified Community Velocity Model. The CSIP software is also publicly released.
What we can do at SCEC that we're really good at is better ground motion modeling and better hazard assessment, which then feeds into the risk. And that allows the engineers to make the correct design decisions and start, for example, retrofitting the most dangerous buildings.
The common thread has been trying to better understand the physics of earthquakes and to use that understanding of the physics to eventually make real practical gains in reducing risk from earthquakes in California.
So once we have that fundamental improved understanding, communicating that to the public and to decision makers and just all the different people who are going to use that information is the purpose of SCEC's communication, education, and outreach program. Perhaps the most successful activity that we do in SCEC CEO spans all of our focus areas, and it's the Great Shakeout Earthquake Drills. And it really was based originally on SCEC science, working together with the U.S. Geological Survey and many partners, and understanding what would happen when a big earthquake on the San Andreas Fault were to occur. And SCEC community models were incorporated, SCEC's work in high-performance computing and visualizing earthquakes, earthquake rupture and wave propagation. All of that was put together to understand how that earthquake, a 7.8 on the southern San Andreas, would affect the whole region.
You know, the center, you know, basically has all this expertise in earthquake sciences. So if you have any sort of problem you want to try to solve in earthquake science, you can go to the center and find the people to do it. The
management team has really been very effective in providing venues for this type of intense scientific collaboration.
It's the collaboration that brings people together. The fact is that all the really key earthquake scientists, certainly in the United States and now from around the world, are involved in SCEC, either through the core institution process, participating institution process.
We have our formal meetings to make sure that, say, the engineers hear what the seismologists say, and the seismologists hear what the earthquake geologists say. And through those fora, people get ideas about new ways of tackling problems.
Once a year, we have this fantastic meeting, the SCEC annual meeting, that brings people together from all over the world to really focus on the earthquake problem, and in particular, to make decisions about how the SCEC collaboration will move forward during the next year.
You know, you get to meet new people, hear about what they're doing, but also see the work that we're doing as a community put in a larger, broader context.
I think what I'd like is a really diverse group of scientists, but with a common goal to really understand the earthquake process.
Basically, since I started working as a graduate student in geophysics back in, I think, 1993 or something like that, so it's been a long time. I was essentially raised in SCEC and came to be a mature scientist in SCEC as well, and I love it.
It felt really nice coming in because I don't know many people in the seismology community. And so it was nice to come here and people just kind of, you know, want to know who you are and they want to know about you and they want to help you.
I'm meeting with my advisor and another colleague to talk about her research. So it's a nice opportunity to meet with people who are on the other side of the country that we don't normally get to talk with.
The poster sessions have been awesome. Just so much good interaction. When you can actually sit down and have an interaction with authors on specific things that you're interested in, can't beat that experience.
SCEC SCEC has this incredibly diverse group of scientists and engineers and other types of earthquake experts that are working together on this problem.
I could never have done what I've done without SCEC having been here to create the information that we then implemented in the city.
One of the benefits of SCEC is that it's a young organization in terms of the people who are involved with it. It's energetic, it's a lot of up-and-coming type people, and so SCEC is, by its very nature, growing and diverse and encouraging the non-standard geologist to be a part of it.
Scientists are often interested in the idea. In some sense, a theoretical idea. We are interested in trying to make sure the theoretical idea leads to a practical result. To me, that collaborative activity requires a willingness to give up kind of personal credit. But if you're willing to do that, then you can work on a scale that's just not possible to work as an individual.
All of the work that I've done for SCEC would not have been possible if other people hadn't given me their data. I like to think of the work as I do as like step three in a 5 or 6 or 100 step process. And so if those first three steps hadn't been done first, I wouldn't be able to do any of this stuff. We'd still be modeling faults as single rectangles, and they're not rectangles.
Earthquakes are an emergent phenomena. They come out of a bunch of dirt and rocks. All of a sudden you get these amazingly complex behaviors. To understand that kind of emergent behavior, you have to put together some model of the entire earthquake system. And that can't be done using the tools of only one discipline. We can't just do it using seismological tools or geological tools or geodetic tools. We have to put all of the different types of observations together in order to understand their behavior.
One kind of result or outcome is increased interactions working with building engineers. Let's combine the information from each of these subfields and use it to create information that's useful to the public.
After an earthquake isn't the best time to get prepared for an earthquake. You want to get prepared in advance. So we created ShakeOut to be something big enough that it would really get a lot of conversations going, that perhaps students come home from having done this drill at their school, their parents have done drills at their workplace, they come home, they talk about what happened during the day, and they can all talk about, well, what will we do at home?
Our hopes is that if we can characterize the seismic hazard and seismic risk here in Southern California, that this information can be used by emergency managers, by power companies, by Caltrans, by people who really will apply this to help reduce the chance of a disaster coming out of the inevitable earthquakes. Because remember, earthquakes are a natural process. They're inevitable. But disasters are human-made, and perhaps they're not inevitable. And so with enough information, maybe we can actually do something about at least the disaster side of the equation.